welcome back to my brand new channel for grown women only. I'm your host, Nikki, and on this show, we talk about love, life lessons, and leveling up. And as you guys know, this is my safe space for women. Gentlemen, you're more than welcome to sit in, but the minute you come for my ladies is the minute I come for you. All right, so I've been dealing with the topic of you, right? And today's topic is why you must date from a high place, right? Why you must date from a high place. Now, the reason I want to talk about this is because a lot of women miss out on very good men or men who could be a potential mate because they are not dating from a high place. Now, when I say a high place, I mean you are emotionally, financially, physically, and mentally together, right? You have handled all the big issues in your life. If you have any daddy issues, mommy issues, financial issues, emotional issues, you have started dealing with your stuff and you are in a place to be receptive, right? A lot of times when women are not dating from a high place or they're dating from a low place, they attract low mates. And the reason I say this is because like attracts like, right? And if you want to date someone as high value, if you want a high value man, then you must in turn be a high value woman. And people are always quoting these marriage statistics about how black people don't get married or black women don't get married, blah, 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 blah. I mean, it's just, it may be true, but it doesn't have to be true for your life because we set the standard on what we as women will accept, right? I also say this as well. When you are dating from a high place, you attract quality, right? Not quantity, but quality. Because think about it. I believe if a woman really wants to get married, she can get married. And she can get married to a high value man. I don't believe in shortage. Because when people say shortage, it's like people say that there's not enough. And when people say there's not enough, to me, it's like desperation. Right? We have to take what's being given to you. And you don't have to take anything that's just being given to you. You need to be selective about your life, right? And in order to be selective, you must date from a high value place. Now, and when you have your mental, your physical, your financial, and your emotional together, right? You are in a great spot to date. And the reason you're in a great spot is because you have done the work. So what you require of someone else is that they have done the work as well. And the two of you will attract each other because there's a vibe, there's a signal, there is a standard that is being communicated without you saying anything, right? And the thing about standards are they are things that we stand on as women, things that we will and will not tolerate in a man. And a lot of times when we don't have standards, that comes off in the way we act. So for example, when you are dating from a high value place, when you have your emotional stuff together, your financial stuff together, your physical stuff together, your mental stuff together, you are in turn going to attract someone who is also like you, right? Because a couple of things happen when you date from a low place. You'll attract dusties. You'll attract broke men. You'll attract men who like to pump and dump. You'll attract men who want to waste your time. You'll attract broken men. And a lot of times, like I said before, I don't believe that black women don't have the chance to get married. We do. But the thing about it is that our picker is off. And when I say our picker, we go for things that are not important in a mate because we haven't done the work on ourselves, which will allow us to qualify a potential mate. For example, when I say people's picker is broke, like, when a woman comes from a home that is not wholesome or where there is no male figure or a woman who is teaching her to live in her femininity, then a lot of times she operates in the masculine, right? And she's looking for a pretty boy. She's looking for a guy to provide a lifestyle that probably eludes him. She will try to build a man into her ideal man. She may be promiscuous. She may waste her time with different gentlemen because she doesn't know that she is dating from a low place, right? But when you date from a high place, honey, let me tell you something. Your criteria changes. Something shifts in you. And people say all the time, right, that there aren't good mates. I'm telling you that is false. If there are over a billion people in the planet, a billion people, and half of them are men, you mean to tell me you can't find one good mate? Girl, of course you can, right? And even that shortage mindset eliminates a lot of people out of the game, because as a man thinketh, so is he. So if you think that you can't find a good guy, or you think there are no good men left, guess what's going to happen? You're not going to find a good guy. You're not going to find a good mate. You have to make room for that thing to show up in your life. Forget that ride and die philosophy. I can't stand that, where you are just going along with this guy and he is going nowhere, right? Forget riding and dying. You just stop the car, ask questions, and get out if it doesn't suit you. The second thing I don't want women to do is build a man, right? Now let's talk about this building a man thing. Now, a lot of guys say, oh, I wanna ride and die, girl, it's gonna suck me where I am. Okay, yeah, that's cool. But for me, leadership is important. And the thing is, how can you lead me anywhere if you don't have a leadership or vision for your own life, right? A lot of us want solid men who know where they're going, what they want, are actively doing it, and have a plan to get there, right? So as women, if we have the standard in our own life, we'll recognize it in someone else's. And the things that a lot of us think are important, like looks, I'm sorry, looks has its place, but it's not the top 10. Height is not the top 10. Like, you will start figuring out what is important. How about integrity? How about ambition? How about a vision for your life? How about honesty? How about commitment, right? Because these are the things in which love is built on, right? I also think that when a woman fixes herself, after she's done so much work on herself, she won't allow someone else in to come in and tear it down. For example, I can talk about weight. That's my thing. When I lost about 60 pounds, right, 60, 70 pounds, and had developed this healthy lifestyle, the last thing I was going to allow was somebody to come in and mess it up. Like, I wouldn't go out to eat as much, right? And if I did eat, I ate half portions, or I ate very healthy food, because I knew what it was like to carry the burden of excessive weight, right? I knew it was like not to be healthy. So why would I turn around and give someone the power to make me unhealthy again once I've done all this work? It's like going forward and taking 10 steps backwards. We don't have time for that. So the ride and die philosophy is gone. The building a man is gone. And like I said, I don't believe that you should build a man. There are certain things a man should come to you with already, right? And if you're communicating this standard, right, and you get smart about your life financially, mentally, and emotionally, right, it will allow you to stay in your feminine, right? So only alpha men who are into providing and taking care of women and doing the right thing will be attracted to you. When a man asks you to build him, that's feminine, right? When a man leads with his looks, that's feminine. And whenever you have a man being feminine, then naturally, the woman's going to turn masculine. You can't have two feminine people or two masculine people. There's going to be a trade-off of energy, right? And because a woman, right, her true nature is not to be masculine. It just isn't. So when she starts operating in her masculine, all types of feelings come up, like resentment, right? Like hate, like distrust, like not being able to count on someone, being non-supportive, being disrespectful. That is how a woman acts out when she's in the feminine. I'm sorry, when a man is in the feminine and she's in the masculine, okay? So like I said, please make sure you're dating from a high place, right? Because quality attracts quality. It's kind of like a dress, right? And women, we know what it's like to have a very expensive dress on. It fits right. It feels right. It complements your body in all the appropriate ways, right? We also know what it's like to have a cheap dress on. It looks cheap, right? It doesn't hang on your body right. It doesn't look good on you. It just looks tacky. When you start to refine yourself and set standards and date from a high value place, think about the analogy of a dress and turn it into the analogy of a man. So you will know what man suits you, what man looks good on you, what man feels right to you, what man compliments you, right? Because your energy will tell you so. Your emotions will guide you, right? Your intuition will let you know you're making the right decision. But when you get with a dusty or a guy that has nothing to offer you, especially these red pill and MGTOW who want to bump and dump or pump and dump, whatever you guys want to call them, your radar will go up and it will say, uh-uh, he's not the man for you. He doesn't feel good. He does not compliment you. He does not suit you. And even if he's trying to be slick about his intentions, your intuition and your gut will start speaking to you. So ladies, please, 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 please do the work and date from a high place. Get yourself clear, be emotionally stable, mentally stable, financially stable, and also what? Mental, emotional, financial. I'm missing one. mental, emotional, financial, physical. Yes. So make sure you are stable, right? And that you have all of your stuff together so you can attract someone who also has all their stuff together. And one more note to Black ladies, do not be afraid to date outside of your race, honey. There are other races of men who find us attractive. And so don't let a low value man who thinks he's high value push that standard off on you saying that, oh, there's only a select Black men who fall in this category. You said Black men. We're talking about men in general. So swirl, honey. I mean, hey, your man might be another color, right? But if he's high value, we'll take him all the same. Bye.